services in Goddard Street. See a Mrs. Foley. They've found a baby abandoned at the rear of their premises.
Right, on way.
Well, if you're going to dump a baby, social services is as good a place as any. Do we know how old it is, Bob?
Yeah, very young, a few days.
And Narika's dealing?
Yeah, she's on the way.
Right, I'll see you there.
Good morning. I'm Heather Foley, Social Services.
WPC Data, Narika.
The baby's in the family room. She's a baby girl, very young, I'd say 4 or 5 days, no more.
You found her?
I did, when I came in this morning as I was parking the car.
Right, what time was this?
Oh, about 10 to 9. Well, here she is. She's been well cared for. She's very clean, I'd say she was bathed before she came out. You can smell the talc. Nice baby grow. Good quality blankets, natural cotton.
Looks like a brand new carry cot.
Oh, that's a safe toy. It's designed for colour and movement. Somebody spent a lot of money on the little darling.
Do you always park in the same place?
Yes, yes. There's an area set aside for each section.
So she was certain to be found?
Mm, yeah, couldn't miss her.
Vince, I'll be back in reception in a couple of minutes, OK?
Excuse me, when did you come on?
I started at 6. Yeah, about the baby, yeah?
That's right. Did you see anyone around this morning, you know, earlier than usual?
Yeah, I did, actually. A woman on her way out. I didn't see her come in, I was on the round.
What time was this?
About 7:30, called away.
Was she on foot?
No, driving. I waved her down. She said she just dropped a letter off.
What sort of car?
Silver Nissan.
Did you get a number?
No, except it was a K-Reg. Sorry, she didn't look like she was out to nick anything.
Can you describe her?
Blonde, sort of curlyish, you know? Oh, and she had dark glasses on.
Anything else?
Yeah, brooch. Big silver crescent-shaped moon here.
This is my car. She was over there on the staff entrance steps.
Right. Do you have security cameras?
No, no. We were meant to be getting them, but they went in the last round of cuts.
Andrew Monroe.
Heather Foley.
Is this where the baby was found?
Yes, sir.
How is she?
The baby seems fine, sir.
She's in remarkable condition, all things considered.
I just spoke to one of your security men. He says that he stopped a woman in a Nissan car between 7:30 and 7:45 this morning. According to him, the woman was in her early 30s, attractive, short blonde hair, wearing a distinctive brooch, silver in the shape of a crescent moon.
You don't recognise anyone from that description?
No, I phoned round my colleagues. There are 3 women whom we consider to be at risk. A lady who's about to give birth to her 8th and is very fed up.
I'm not surprised.
And 2 teenage pregnancies who've been kicked out.
No Nissan cars, then?
Yeah, it's a bit out of our league. Usually when they drop them off here, they're wrapped in woolen blankets and left in a cardboard box, still blooded, nearly dead.
They found her yet?
No.
2 hours, isn't it? After that, they reckon it gets easier for the mother to stay away. The ties get broken.
Oh, they'll find her. He's some schoolgirl. She'll faint at assembly.
I think they should let them go.
Who's that?
Mothers who abandon their babies.
How'd you work that one out?
We're meant to do what's best for the kid. I don't see how reuniting a child with a mother who's dumped it is the best thing for it. Doesn't solve anything.
They're desperate, Steve. That's why they do it.
Well, there's plenty of single mothers out there with nothing who manage to cling on, all right?
It's the worst thing a mother can do.
No, it isn't. They give it up to give the kid a better chance in life. I think we're wrong to try and put them back together. We don't know if it's going to do any good, do we? I mean, we hope they'll live happily ever after, but we don't know. Get it adopted every time for me.
Well, I'm glad we worked that one out. Reg!
Yes, sir, how can I help you?
I'd like to talk to someone about the abandoned baby.
And your name is?
Adam Scott.
All right, so if you'd like to take a seat, Mrs. Scott.
I'll take this, Reg. Mr. Scott?
Yes.
I'm WPC Data.
Adam, I heard the appeal on the radio.
All right, would you come this way?
Thanks.
You know something about the baby?
She might be mine.
But you don't know?
No. Sounds daft, this. Sorry. I think the baby could be my girlfriend's.
Sit down.
Thanks.
What's your girlfriend's name?
Annie Grant. I was going out with her at school.
And where is she now?
I don't know. She went away. Her mother took her away. Annie would have been having the baby about now. But her mother said she'd had a miscarriage.
You don't believe her?
No, she was lying. I asked to see Annie and she said no. She said Annie wouldn't see me. I don't believe that.
It's a bit of a long shot, isn't it, Adam?
They said on the radio he wanted to talk to a woman who drove the silver Nissan car. Jane Grant, Annie's mum. She drives a silver Nissan.
Yeah, just one second. Sarge, like a reporter, they've been tipped off that a baby's been found abandoned.
Give them the number of the press bureau.
Yeah, hello? Yeah, all calls are being referred to the press bureau. Yeah, well, I'm sorry. We can't give you any more information at present, though. Thank you.
Okay.
Do we want their help or don't we?
Sir, I've got a young lad in the front office who thinks he might be the father of our baby.
On what basis?
Well, his pregnant girlfriend's due. She was taken away by her mother, who says her daughter lost the baby, but he doesn't believe this. The mother's in her early 30s, has blonde curly hair, and she drives a silver Nissan.
Hello, Adam. I'm Andrew Monroe. WPC data tells me that you think you might be able to help us trace the mother of the baby that was found this morning.
Yes.
Excellent. You're at school?
I was at school. I'm at sixth form college. I met Annie there.
That's Annie Grant, sir.
We went out together for a couple of years.
And which school was this?
Canley Comp.
Right, and Annie discovered she was pregnant. When was that?
About 7, 8 months ago. She said she'd missed a period. Then she missed a second, and we bought a kit, and it was positive.
What did you do about it?
Annie didn't want to tell her mum. Not straight away.
Is she that bad?
Yes and no. She was never too keen on me.
How old's Annie, Adam?
Annie's 15.
And her mum?
Early 30s.
So, Annie's pregnant and she decides to have the baby?
Yes. She made the decision and we started to plan. We wouldn't live together, but I'll play a full part. I would be involved. We even bought a few things.
When did you tell her mother?
She found out. She asked.
And she wasn't happy?
She threatened to phone the police when I went round.
Didn't Annie try and stay in touch?
Yeah, we talked a few times on the phone. She and her mum are very close. They've always been on their own together. It was hard for her. Anyway, I went round to try again, and they'd moved.
Where to, Adam?
I don't know.
Where does she work?
Murtaugh's.
The estate agent?
Yes. We used to use the empty places, Annie and me. She'd nick the keys from her mum. It was somewhere to go.
You said you started to make plans.
Yeah.
Bought a few things.
Yeah.
A pram? A cot?
We didn't have that much money.
Or clothes, then?
A few. You never know which colour. Annie wanted a boy.
What about toys?
It's difficult. Nowadays, everything's reckoned to be dangerous. We ended up with a soft toy. A mobile.
Can you describe it?
We can never decide on what it was meant to be. Some kind of fish.
Please, come this way. It's just that we never give the addresses of our employees out over the phone. Especially the women. You can't be too careful these days.
Of course.
Oh, please, sit down. Here.
Thank you.
Now, how can I help you? I hope it's nothing serious, not an accident or anything.
It's an inquiry. She's not in any trouble.
Good.
Has Mrs. Grant been with you long?
About 10 years. She started part-time, secretarial. Very efficient. Sorted out the office. Worked her way up from there.
And what does she do now?
She's a member of the sales team. Mostly repossessions at the moment. She sells them off.
Is she in the office today?
No. She's been working from home.
How long has she been doing that?
Is this about the youth?
Which youth is that, sir?
Well, Jane's being followed. I thought that might be why you're here. I thought she might have complained.
Followed by whom, sir?
By her daughter's boyfriend. Apparently she gave him the shove and he won't take no for an answer. He started pestering her. They had to move house. He's even been round here a few times.
If Mrs. Grant wants us to have a word with the young man...
I think that would be a very good idea. But you must ask Jane first. She's working from home for most of the day. Here's her address.
Mrs. Grant?
Yes?
I'm Andrew Monroe from Sun Hill, and this is WPC Data. I wonder if you might have a word.
What about?
About your daughter, Annie, Mrs. Grant.
Is anything wrong?
Not that we know of. Could you tell us where she is?
Can we come inside? Annie's on holiday with her pen pal.
Do you have an address?
They're backpacking. What is this about?
We're trying to trace the mother of a baby abandoned at the social services department in Goddard Street this morning.
So why come here? We were told Annie was pregnant. Well, she was, but she lost it. Who sent you here?
If she had gone full term, she would have been giving birth around now, wouldn't she?
You're not listening. Annie lost her baby 5 months ago.
We're very concerned for the health of the missing mother, Mrs. Grant.
I know who sent you here. It's Adam Scott, isn't it? This isn't the first time he's done something like this.
Our main concern at this time...
You don't believe me, do you? Do you want to look around? Do you want to come and see her bedroom? Come on, I'll show you. I can't believe this is happening to me. That's the airing cupboard. Up here, we have the bathroom. And this is my bedroom. Come on, have a good look around, feel free. This is Annie's room.
Please, come in.
Thank you. Feel free to look under the bed. This is the wardrobe. I can see she's not here, Mrs. Grant. I don't know what you consider reasonable in the way of evidence, but you'll notice the empty coat hangers. She's taken 3 pairs of shoes and her rucksack is gone. I'm quite satisfied that Annie's no longer in the house. There is a loft. It's all right. Sorry, I can't be more help.
Is this Annie, Mrs. Grant?
Oh, yes, it is. I hope you're not thinking of taking that. She's not missing.
Can you tell us where you were between 7 and 8 this morning?
Do I need a lawyer?
I don't know. Do you? You haven't answered my question.
I left about 7:15. I had several calls to make, and I stopped off at the social services on my way to drop off a letter.
What time would that have been?
About 7:30-ish.
What was the letter concerning?
My mother's home help, she's disabled. Perhaps you'd like to go and ransack her house as well.
We're sorry to have troubled you, Mrs. Grant.
Yes, I'm sure you are. Sir, remember the security guard said something about a brooch, a silver crescent brooch?
Uh-huh.
Well, there was a jacket upstairs of one just like it.
Check out the home help story, we'll work from there.
Yes, Reg.
How's it going?
We think we know who the mother is, but we can't find her.
We've had loads of calls. Mostly people asking how the baby is, even offering to adopt her.
Have you got a number for the social services?
Yeah, it'll be on
yes,
here.
Yes, she is. Just on there.
We interviewed this woman in connection with a sighting there. She said she was posting a letter about home help. I need to check it out.
Yeah, I'll tell her.
Narika, there's a woman at the front desk who wants to talk to you about her neighbour. You were around there about half an hour ago, apparently.
Right.
Narika.
Thanks.
Oh, I saw you earlier at my neighbour's. I'm Mrs. Jukes.
Yes, madam.
Well, it was about the baby, wasn't it? I thought of her, you know, as soon as I heard. Do you think it's her daughter's?
What? Do you mean Annie?
Well, to be honest, I don't know the girl's name. They keep themselves very private.
What makes you think the baby might be Annie's?
Well, last week, Sunday, you can see over from my bedroom window. She was sitting in the shade, and it was very hot, and she looked exhausted, poor little thing, and so young too. And I was thinking, she's due any minute, and I haven't seen her since. That's when I made the connection.
Well, I'm very glad you did, Mrs. Dukes. Would you mind making a statement? It won't take long.
Oh, anything you want.
Where is she now, then?
Well, we can ask Jane Grant.
She'll deny it. She's hiding her somewhere.
Adam Scott said they used to use keys for places that Jane Grant was selling.
Can you give us an idea where to start?
Somewhere not too big, neat, pleasant, somewhere private.
Oh, well, Jane handles a riverside development, a luxury flat, so there are 3 or 4 of them left. I could take you there.
Thank you.
It's locked from the inside.
But it's supposed to be empty, isn't it?
Yeah, vacant possession.
You speak.
Bar. Annie? Oh, dear. It's all right. You're all right.
I thought you were Mum.
Thanks for your help.
Annie?
I had no idea.
Shall we go in there?
No.
Nothing's wrong?
No.
They're all right?
Yes.
Baby, all right?
The baby's fine.
It's a relief.
Do you have a name for her yet?
No, we decided not to give her a name.
Oh, who did?
Me, Mum. We thought it would be harder to part with a little Rosie or Jude. That's what we thought.
How are you feeling?
I'm fine. I'm tired. Mum says I'll get over that.
Yeah, you will.
I can't sleep, though. I'm all over the place.
Well, that's to be expected.
Yeah, Mum said that too. What are you doing here, then?
We came to see how you are.
Bad day, that's all.
Why's that?
Handover day. She's gone to an American couple.
Your baby?
Yes. They're really nice.
Oh, you've met them?
No, my mum said.
Right. Good. Do you like it here, then?
Nice views. A bit lonely. I'm not used to being on my own.
No, I can imagine.
It's just a short-term thing. Then back home, start again, like nothing happened. GCSEs next year.
Annie, do you feel up to coming to Sun Hill with us?
Why?
We need to ask you some questions.
Why not? I'll get dressed.
Right.
All units from Sierra Oscar 1. Can someone bring Mrs. Jane Grant to the station, please?
Saving.
Yeah, she's at the Hazelmere, which is at 35 Marlowe's Wharf.
Yeah, Oscar 1 from 363. I'll do that.
Yeah, Dave, re your PI. Last
registered
keeper, and Mr.
S. Found the baby's mother.
Where?
In a flat down by the river.
Oh, good. How is she?
She's fine. She's coming in.
Good.
Is my daughter here? Is Annie Grant here?
I don't know.
Is she still recovering?
She is she?
Can we just stop for a minute?
Hang on, Steve.
Sorry, I just feel a bit dizzy, that's all.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. This is Michelle. She'll stay with you until we can talk.
Hello.
Hi. Just make yourself as comfortable as you can. It shouldn't be too long.
Do you want a cup of tea or coffee?
No, thanks. Do you know if my mum's coming?
Yes, she'll be here.
I'd feel better if she was.
Where is Annie? I'd like to see her, please.
She's here and she's fine. We'll want to speak to her later.
Well, I can't think why.
Can't you?
I've done nothing wrong.
On the contrary, Mrs. Grant. I have reason to believe that you have committed an offence under Section 1 of the Children and Young Persons Act. Why did you abandon a small baby outside the social services offices this morning?
I thought they'd take care of it.
Really?
Yeah. I did it for the baby. I did it for Annie.
How do you think it helps Annie?
She's only 15. She's bright and intelligent. She can be anything she wants.
Except her mother, apparently.
How old were you when you had Annie? 17. Year into sixth form, heading for university. What happened? Took a risk, didn't I? One drunken night at a party, and I remember thinking as I was going away, don't ever do that again. So you got married? That was all I needed. There I was. Wedded. In a council flat, with a baby. Oh, it was madness. Annie said you talked about the baby. We're best mates. I told her it was a bad mistake.
And Annie agreed that the steps of the social services building was the most efficient means of disposal of this inconvenient child.
No, I did that. Annie didn't have anything to do with that. I told her we'd get the baby adopted. And then when it arrived, she started to get attached to it, and I panicked. I told her that I found this really nice American couple, but we had to move really fast because they were going back. I told her, I kept reminding her, don't tie yourself down.
It hasn't quite worked out, has it?
No. How are you feeling?
I'm all right now.
Good.
Glad to be out the flat.
I bet you are. This is Heather.
Hello.
Hi.
Now, I'd like to ask you a few questions, if you think you can manage it.
Okay.
Right. When was the baby born?
She's 5 days old. I don't know what date it is.
It's the 19th.
The 14th, then.
And did you have a doctor or a midwife?
Private doctor.
Did you go to the flat of your own free will, Annie?
I don't want to get Mum into any trouble. It's not fair. We agreed to do it. We talked it through.
It's okay, Annie.
Good. What's happening to the baby, then? Has she gone?
No, she hasn't gone.
Where is she?
She's in care.
What about the American couple?
Annie, there was no American couple. Your baby was left at social services.
How did that happen?
Your mum did it.
I don't believe you. Has she said so?
Yes, she has.
No.
I'm sorry.
Where is she?
She's here at the station.
Do you want to see her?
Yes, I do.
Right.
Oh, Annie. Mrs. Grant. Mrs. Heather Foley. She'll be Annie's social worker.
Social worker? We don't need a social worker.
Well, we're responsible for Annie's welfare, Mrs. Grant.
Well, can't she come home?
Well, she can for now. Annie has expressed a wish to come home.
I didn't say that.
I'm sorry.
I said I wanted to see her.
Right.
Annie, I think we should go home.
They say there was never any American couple ready to adopt the baby, Mum.
Oh, I don't want to talk about it now.
Was there?
Let's go home.
Look, you've never lied to me. Tell me there was. Tell me their names.
I can't. I'm so sorry. I was going to find a couple and then I just panicked.
You lied!
Mrs. Grant, Annie's free to go home with you if she wishes. As Inspector Munro informed you, there will be a report.
Can I see my baby?
Oh, no.
Can I see my baby now?
What?
Yes.
What if I wanted to try and keep the baby?
Well, we'd help you all we could. There'd be a case conference. We'd have to assess it.
What about somewhere for us to live?
You've already got a home.
Would you help with that?
Yes, we could do that.
Will you take me to see her now?
Yes.
Right. We should go. Get started. Thanks for all you've done.
Good luck.